Welcome back to Chem Reactor. In today's video, we are going to discuss yet another important topic in organic synthesis, HATU coupling and the challenges associated with the byproducts generated from these HATU couplings. First, we will see the HATU coupling, its structure and the mechanism. This is the structure of this HATU coupling reagent. It has this azabenzotriazole ring, a guanidine functional group, and then to counter this positive ion, it has this PF6 negative ion. This is a highly efficient coupling reagent in organic synthesis, so that's why it's widely used in carboxylic acid amidation reaction. And yet another reason why organic chemists prefer using this HATU coupling is it has really less enantiomerization properties, so that's why it makes very important coupling reagent, especially in the peptide chemistry. And this is a very simple reaction to do this coupling reaction. So here you just need to charge a Huenisch base like a dipyr or triethylamine and DMF or DCM as a solvent. Here is the mechanism of this HATU coupling reaction. Here a base abstracts this carboxylic acid proton that makes it a carboxylic anion. This carboxylic anion adds to this guanidine functional group in this HATU molecule. This generates this intermediate C, along with that this hydroxy azabenzotriazole anion intermediate. This anion again adds to this ester functional group, and then that generates this tetramethylurea and PF6 as a byproduct from this reaction. So here in the next step, then this amine in the reaction adds to this ester of this intermediate, and then it forms this final product amine, and along with that it also generates another byproduct, hydroxy azabenzotriazole. As we have seen that from the reaction mechanism of this HATU coupling reaction, it generates this tetramethylurea and hydroxy azabenzotriazole as a byproducts. I have done postdoc in medicinal chemistry, and during the postdoc I made like more than 200 amide bonds. During this amide bond formation, HATU was my first choice because it's a very simple reaction. You just need to add starting materials, HATU, dipyr, and then DCM or DMF as a solvent. But during this amide bond formation, I faced some problems or the challenges. So here we'll see one by one. The first one is tetramethylurea impurity. This tetramethylurea impurity is polar impurity that don't get washed out in the workup. Even if you do repetitive columns like more than 2-3 times, it's not that easy to remove this impurity. So I applied another concept, polar, non-polar things, to get my pure product. Since I was working in a medicinal chemistry, I just needed like a few milligrams of compounds to run the biological assays. So for that, I used to dissolve this in the non-polar solvents like heptane or hexane, and then water extraction. That's how I used to purify my compounds. But the problem is here you're gonna lose some product. Because if you have a polar product, your your product won't be dissolved in hexane. So that's another first problem with this HATU coupling reagent. And the second challenge associated with this HATU coupling reagent is the reaction with other nucleophilic functional groups. Here, if you are trying to make this type of amide bonds, and at the same time you have a reactant, reactive functional groups like OH or SH in your reactant, then these functional groups can react with this HATU coupling reagent, and then it can form this impurities. Then the another challenge associated with this HATU coupling reagent is the generation of hydroxy azabenzotriazole. This hydroxy azabenzotriazole is explosive. That's why on a small scale working in a medicinal chemistry, that's fine to work on this, but especially in the process chemistry or the larger scale, this won't qualify for the manufacturing. So in conclusion, the drawbacks of HATU is it develops an allergy, especially a potential to modify human proteins. Then as we have seen that the TMU impurity, that may damage the fertility or the unborn child. The second is contamination of your product with TMU. You may get impurity this in all your products if you don't purify properly. And then the third one with this TMU is the coupling with other reactive functional groups, as we have seen the hydroxy reaction with this guanidine functional group. And in final, it generates this explosive hydroxy azabenzotriazole. I hope you enjoyed the video, and please don't forget to like the video and subscribe the channel. Thank you.